make it short and hopefully sweet because we're all impinging on lunchtime. So thanks to many of you who participated in the survey, and one of the reasons why I think CPT and I, along with Kumar, were discussing why we should do this survey is that retail is perhaps one sector that needs CFOs more than anybody else. I mean, on which industry do you have the global players, you know, either making 1%, 2% margin? So a little bit mistake here and there can really make the difference between a profit and a loss. And as I keep on working with many of the global players, I realize how much the finance and the CFO team, how much of the machinery they are to enable the retail, which is, I have not seen it in India to that extent, but I'm sure things will change. So that was the thought behind looking, talking to CFOs on what is their agenda. Because if you talk to the business people, we always know, you know, we want to grow. This is the great about consumer. This is all about consumption, the India story. But, you know, if you look at last decade, a lot of the things which we said great things about haven't happened. And that's where a CFO's role or the CFO's position becomes critical. On one hand, we have a consumer industry that has done everything right, achieved a lot of growth and profitability. On the other hand, we have a retail industry which is actually serving the same person or the same set of people.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. At the cost of repeating what Pinaki just mentioned slightly differently, I think the two toughest sessions are the pre-lunch and the post-lunch session. And I have been tasked to keep you engaged for another 15-odd minutes. So I hope what I have to share with you will keep you interested. So before I begin, can I request with a show of hands how many participants here are aware of something called as PCI DSS? Well, that's good. I think about 40%. And how many entities who are attending here today are actually going about implementing this PCI DSS in their environment? Okay, little less, but good. At least we have a few. So that's what I'm going to be covering in the short time. We're going to look at the threat landscape, the payment ecosystem, something which you all are quite aware of, an overview of PCI DSS and why it has suddenly gained importance, because it's been around for a while, and what has been HDFC Bank's approach towards the PCI DSS compliance. If you look at the threat landscape today, we've all been seeing for the last 12 to 18 months quite regularly newspaper reports that certain individuals have got phished. The word phishing has gained prominence. You would be having your respective IT and information security teams who would be running you through these reports, the analysis, the impact as far as your entity is concerned. These are some of the names which you may identify with. The most recent being Target. Now this retailer was very recently hit with a scam, and you have Neiman Marcus, you have Harbor Freight, you have MacPo Express. You may wonder why we don't see any Indian names here, although they have been hit. The reason being that it doesn't get reported openly as yet. So while there are retailers, maybe some of them may be here in this room, who have got hit in a small way, but nonetheless, unless it's officially out, we can't show those names here. And what has happened with them? These names that you see, Jack Boss, Dexter, Chewbacca. Now Chewbacca, if you are a sci-fi fan, I am one, so in Star Wars, there was this animated creature called Chewbacca who was a crazy guy who used to go do things on his own. So there is this Trojan, if I may use the word. It's a malicious executable, all of them, the Postram Trojan. And what exactly do they do? So just in the previous presentation, Pinaki had mentioned that, you know, the entire outlook looks positive. Well, if you ask me, while I am from the financial domain and I am working with the bank in the information security group, I'll say it's not very positive, it's a little bit grim. Reason being that most of the payment ecosystem today is vulnerable. We may be saying that, you know, we've got a fantastic growth rate, we've got retail taking over big time, we've got people getting snapped up at unheard of prices in billions of dollars. But at the same time, we need to understand that what is it that we are trying to achieve at the end of the day? What Pinaki brought out was, show me the money. And while you may be wanting to do it for all the right reasons, there are people out there who are leveraging technology for the wrong reasons. Now, a very simple case, which I will take you through when I take you through the payment ecosystem slide, would be that you have your end customer, then there's you, and then there is either a bank or a service provider who's facilitating the entire payment chain. And how it gets exploited is what we need to look at. This particular slide is of absolute relevance today in the Indian retail scenario. Now, if you look at it, most of you will identify with it that at the point of sale,